There he is, right by the boat. Oh, let's see what we got. Oh, I'm fishing a really unique way today, y'all. Nice speckled trout. Now, I know if you've watched some of my videos, you know that I like to fish a drop shot a lot. But we're in the spring now, and springtime, we know that we're gonna have flood tides. Nice boat, I don't know, 14-inch speckled trout. We throw him back. See you later, buddy. And what we're doing is we're fishing a drop shot, but because during the spring we have really hard tides, I did my charter this morning, had a great day. We had falling tides, low water, came back out to come film, and guess what? Now the water's rolling in and it's getting high. And what you have to do is you have to understand that it's going to be very hard to be able to feel when a fish bites. It's just, that's the way it happens when you have hard current. So what I did was I rigged up a drop shot. I got me a 3/8 ounce weight on the bottom. It's just one of those little style weights to the bottom weight. But what I did was I put a circle hook. And the reason why I did a circle hook was is because when these fish bite, I'm just going to feel the weight. I'm not going to actually feel the actual bite or the strike. And using a circle hook, you don't have to set the hook. You can just start reeling. There's no hook set needed. And then you'll catch them that way. So I just threw it about 3 times and caught that fish. I'm going to try to see. The current's rolling so hard, I've got to kind of figure them out and see if they're here. I haven't fished here since last fall. But that was the first fish. Good one. So we'll see what happens. Now I'm using live shrimp. So I hook them this way. Whenever I'm doing drop shot, I want to hook them through the horn. So if you look right here, that circle hook has a special little tip on there. You're gonna go right behind the black dot, come out in the head, and there it is. He can move around, swim around. It looks kind of realistic, but I'm gonna be honest with you. The current's moving so hard, he's just going through, and they're feeding if he's there. So we'll see. I'm throwing way up current so I can come across next to this flat that's right here. It looks like it just is a flat and it drops off. And those fish hold on that drop off for me. So we're going to try it. This is a high current spot and I'll explain it after. There he is. Oh, there's one. Now that was way in the back of the tide. Came right up to the surface. The tide's rolling so hard, y'all. These fish are getting pushed right up to the surface when they hit. Now, what I'm doing is that this is what I would consider probably one of the strongest tides today that I've had since, you know, beginning of January, and we're right now beginning of April. And what's happening is that these big rushes of tides that are coming through, these fish have got to locate themselves to where they can, number one, they can find bait. Number two, they don't exert more energy than what the bait that they'll actually eat, because if that's the case, they won't survive. They've got to eat to sustain that. And the last thing is, these fish locate where the tide is moving, but they don't want to move in super hard, but they want to be able to go against the tide so they can, you know, more or less, they can ambush their bait. So we're going to try it again, but what we have here is we have a point right there. The water's rolling around the point. It's coming down, and there's a flat right here, and it's just, all it is like a shelf. It's like a swimming pool. You got a shallow deck, and then it just drops off, and those fish are on that drop-off. So we'll see. That's the second one. I mean, that was cast after cast, so we're going to see. Now, because it's early spring, we always know most of our shrimp are really small. So when you hook them, you got to be really delicate with them because They just kind of, you know, it's all small shrimp. It's little bitty ones that are just starting. But even though they're small, it doesn't matter because that's what the fish are actually seeing out in the water too. So that's what they're preying on. So let's throw back up current. All right, there he is. Oh, let's see what it is. Oh, he got off right there. I think, y'all, believe it or not, I think that was just a pretty decent sized croaker. So we got croakers on the bottom, and everybody knows big speckled trout love croakers. They love them. So maybe they'll have some big specks. Try that again. Oh, goodness. Oh, I couldn't keep up with him, y'all. That's one of the things with hard current. I hit him. I had him on for a second, but he ran out, and it was super hard for me to catch up with him. I've got my reel today. I'm using this Concept C, but this has an 8-to-1 ratio on this reel. So I got a really fast ratio, but still, fish are fast, and when they hit you and run out to deeper water, man, sometimes you just can't catch up to them. It's just the way it goes. So, all right, let me try it again. And I'm not used to using circle hooks, and I set the hook on that one, and that's a no-no with a circle hook. You got to just reel. So I had a kind of a a little flaw there, but we'll get them on the next cast. Oh, I set the hook again. I'm not supposed to set the hook. Oh, shoot. All right, let's see what this is. This feels like a really good fish. Now, I'll tell you, I set the hook on this fish. You're not supposed to do that with a circle hook. It's supposed to help not having to set the hook, but we'll see what it is. Oh, nice little redfish. Nice. So all of the species are here because they're feeding on the new shrimp that are coming in from out in the Gulf. The Gulf is probably about 2 miles away from me right here, and the fish, they're starting to feed on the shrimp that are coming in. We're hearing that the shrimp are coming in really good because the guys that catch our bait at Campo's, old Zach Campo, he's over there catching the bait for us, and he told us, man, they're catching a lot of bait right now, just like all of a sudden showed up. So we know these fish are looking for these shrimp too. Look at that beautiful fish. I love it. And then our limit here in Louisiana so far is 16 inches to 27 inches. So he's a keeper. He's about 17 and a half, maybe. He ain't 18, but he's between 16 and 17. Beautiful fish. Let's release him back in and let him go. Look, you can see how hard the current's moving. I mean, it's just crazy. But these fish are stacked up, and I'm excited about it because I wanted to try this spot today when I had my charter, but we just didn't get a chance to. And the fish are here, so I'm gonna sit here and catch them. How's that sound? All right, everybody, now I'm catching these fish, but I wanna show you how to rig this up, okay? I have my tackle box, got my different weights and stuff in it. This is a 3/8 ounce bottom rig. It's just a little sinker for bottom. You're gonna tie just a normal half hitch, trilene, I mean, whatever you wanna call it, cinch knot, okay? So we're gonna put that on here on the bottom of our line that goes back to our rod, okay? Now, we got that. You can put the hook wherever you want on this line. I'm fishing about 8 to 12 inches. So what I'm doing is, let me get a circle hook. I've got me a circle hook right here. Now, it's very easy. This line goes back to my rod. I'm gonna actually bend my 30 pound leader right here. I'm gonna bend it in half, and I'm gonna put it in the eye of this circle hook, okay? And it takes a little bit to push it through there because at 30 pound test, it's pretty thick, but you gotta get it through it. So you push it through, okay, we got it through. Now, it's hanging on the line. It's doubled over and coming through. You're just gonna make an overhand knot. And then when you make the overhand knot, you got a loop right here. Just take and pass your hook back through that loop, okay? So we're gonna go, pass it through. Now it looks like a lot of mess right here, but it's really not. You just pull that tight. After a couple times of doing it, it's very easy. And then there's your rig. Your hook is about 8 to 12 inches. This goes to the bottom, and that shrimp's jumping around and doing everything it needs to do, a croaker, or you can even put an artificial on here. It doesn't matter. It works perfect for this type of situation. Oh, what's it got? What we got? What we got? Oh, look at that, y'all. So all water's right now, because it's spring. We have a lot of fresh water because the Mississippi River's high. Look what we got here. Old freshwater catfish. So that's three species so far, and oh, four, because we had the little croaker. So that lets you know these are really good eating. He's kind of small, but boy, you talking about good eating these little catfish. And I know all of y'all from up north, I can tell you, you go, oh, those things, we catch them all the time. We don't catch them here a lot. So when we catch them, we get excited because we don't catch a whole bunch of them. And it's really fun because when you find them, a lot of times there's hundreds of them and you can just fill ice chests up with them. Because here in Louisiana, I'm not positive because we never get up that many, but you can keep like 100 or 125 of those things. It's pretty awesome. So I need to get a rag because he is so slimy. All right, now I have my micro shrimp on here because they're so small on this rig. Now, this is the way you want to do it. Our current is rolling down. So you don't want to throw perpendicular to the boat or behind it because the bait will never be able to get to the bottom because the current will pull it up. Even though it's got this weight on it, the amount of displacement on the line, the shrimp, the weight itself, it's all gonna pull it up. So what you have to do is you have to throw, okay, on an angle in front of your boat, not straight in front, just a little bit of an angle in the front. And what you're gonna do, you're gonna throw it out, let it hit the bottom. Now right there where I hit the bottom, that's only about maybe 2 foot deep, but I know that it drops off right here. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm just gonna slowly kind of pull it because I'm going down that drop off. I'm not trying to move the bait a whole bunch on my own. I'm letting the current do everything for me. And then I just want to go. I can feel the bait hitting the bottom, hitting oysters. It's slowing it down. It's kind of, it's stuck on an oyster right now, which is fine. I kind of hop it a little bit, let it keep going. And what's going to happen is, that's an oyster. You'll find that, like, a lot of times you may not feel the bite because you got so much line out because of the displacement of the water that you won't feel the bite. It'll feel like almost like a tug. It'll just feel like something's pulling on your line. And when that happens, you pull back slowly, the fish won't spit the hook. He's just going to hold on to it. And then what you do is you pull back slowly, and as you do, he'll kind of pull or jerk a little bit. And when that happens, just start reeling with that circle hook, and you'll get him every time, okay? And that's just a perfect way of working that bait down this thing. You're just more or less letting the current make it look natural, okay? So that's how you work the bait down a place or a shelf like this. All right, let's throw it up, micro shrimp up there and see. All right, I remember just the reel this time. Let's see what we got. Seems like a pretty good fish. Might be another redfish. Yep, another little red. So those redfish are stacked here. The trout are stacked here. So we know both species are here. And for somebody who's out here, this is great for children. I know it seems like it'd be a hard way to fish. It's not. Very easy for kids, super easy. It casts a lot, it's easy to cast, it's easy to feel a strike. I mean, it literally just feels, it's another nice little about 16 and a half incher. It actually just feels like something tugging on your line. So as, you know, new anglers that are out fishing and you're just trying to find fish, you know, we're sitting right now in about 15 feet of water. Up there is about 2. It comes down, drops right off to 15, and these fish seem to be right when they've fallen off the drop off. And these distinct spots like this, this is not anything, this is just a bayou that has some curves and bends in it. And all I did was, when I found this spot years ago, I was just idling. You just gotta idle down, and you'll see, like, you'll be going along and all of a sudden it's 15 foot and then boom, it goes up to 2.5 feet. When that happens, you know that's a good ledge. So then you start looking like, where's the water gonna break to come around it? And you just start fishing. It's trial and error. A lot of times it's not like, hey, spot A, spot B, spot C. You gotta kind of pattern them, figure out a spot, then replicate this. Once you do it once, if the fish slow down, go find another spot that's exactly like it on the same day in the same conditions, and you'll catch fish. And then you'll know every time that happens, you do the same thing every time. Pattern fishing 101. All right, let's get another one of these little micro shrimp and try it again. Oh, I got one, and I didn't set the hook. I was a good guy. Good boy, good boy. All right, y'all, another speckled trout. Look at that. I'm gonna tell y'all, I can't say that I could catch them any faster than I did. I'm not kidding, it's every cast. And one of the things is, now he's a keeper at 12 inches, but now in Louisiana they switched it to 13. He's probably about 12 and a half. I'm gonna check him real quick. Let's see what he is. 12 and a half. Boy, I'm right on it. But I'm hurrying to get him in so he doesn't die. But the thing is that this type of fishing, what I'm trying to show you is that high current situations, majority of the time, it's really tough to catch fish because it's just hard to put your bait in the strike zone long enough that those fish have the ability to feed. And to do that, you have to do rigs like this, because what it's doing is, it's on the bottom, the shrimp is here. As this kind of gets pushed by the current, this weight gets kind of caught up in the oyster shells on the bottom, slows the bait down to keep it in the strike zone longer. And it keeps the bait off the bottom enough to where it's in the strike zone for the fish, because the fish aren't sitting on the bottom, they're swimming. And what they're doing is, they're suspending off the bottom about a foot, foot and a half. That's what they do in heavy current. They won't be high in the column. They'll be low in the column. They want to get down low, and they want to just be right off the bottom. So this rig right here is perfect. Now, sometimes what I'll do is, if I have, you know, high current and I'm working and I'm fishing, I might have 2 or 3 of these rigged up. One might be at 1 foot, one might be at 2 foot, one might be at 3 foot. Majority of the time, I'm going to tell you, about 1 foot is perfect. It works every single time. But this rig, super easy, and I promise you, you use it a couple of times, you're going to find out that this is a way in high current situations and in regular current, but I just like to use it in high current. You'll be a more productive fisherman, and I promise you, No doubt whatsoever, you will catch more fish with this rig. Hey, I hope to see y'all in the water. Make sure y'all subscribe below and make sure you give us any hints or questions or anything down below and I'll answer them for y'all. See you next time in the water.